When's the right time to say goodbye? It's one of life's toughest challenges, and it's no different at Auckland Zoo. Over the past month, the zookeepers have faced some heartbreaking decisions about the fate of their majestic lions, Kura and Amira. Sunday's cameras were given exclusive access to follow them. Jahan Kasanada has a story and a warning: some of this material may be upsetting.
Come on.
For Lauren Booth, mornings begin with her furry companion. But her fussiest felines are waiting at work.
I love my job. I couldn't think of doing anything else.
When I'm heading to work in the morning, I'm just thinking about what the day has in store and kind of getting a rough plan of how everything's going to work.
You can't plan too much because with animals, you never know what's going to happen and what might change.
Morning.
Lauren heads up the carnivores team.
So we'll just head to lions first thing and get them sorted for the morning.
She's in charge of Auckland Zoo's most demanding residents.
Hi, Koo. Hey, Mira. Okay, we'll get you some breakfast.
From the outside, it's business as usual. But the lives of these big cats are on the line.
We know things aren't right.
Auckland Zoo has been an icon of the city for nearly a century. And the jewel in the zoo's crown?
Hiya!
It's pride of lions.
A pride system is normally made up of females that are related, and the bonds are incredibly important. The males can come and go sometimes, but the females, they stick together.
The zoo once had 11 lions in its pride. Now there are just two. There's Kura, the matriarch. She's 19.
You don't mess with Kura, she's the boss. I could just imagine her out there in the wild. She's a real liony lion, whereas Amira can be a bit of a sook.
Amira is Kura's 17-year-old daughter.
She really does rely on her mum. They only have each other.
And they have Lauren.
My goodness, morning breath.
Who's looked after them for 7 years. She loves them to pieces, but how they feel about her? Well, it's complicated.
What would happen if you went into the enclosure?
If I went into the enclosure, I would not come out of the enclosure.
They'd kill you?
Yeah, and I'm under no illusion about that, yeah. They are in captivity, and so our job is to make their life as comfortable and dynamic as possible.
That means providing meals on wheels, free healthcare, and in-house entertainment.
We genuinely believe the animals here have a privileged existence.
Zoo director Kevin Bewley says lions have a better life in Auckland than they do on the savannah.
The wild is not a nice place. The vast majority of animals in the wild will die horrible deaths, particularly lions. The animals here don't experience that. What that means is that they live for much, much longer, and therefore they start to experience the symptoms of old age.
Just like humans, zoo animals can develop arthritis, blindness, and heart trouble.
1, 2, 3.
And lions are no exception. In March, Kura had her annual medical check under the watchful eye of the zoo's top vet.
We do a full examination, we take x-rays, we take bloods, a urine sample. The result of her check was that it was all predominantly normal. We had an elderly lioness who was doing reasonably well. And actually we were quite pleasantly surprised at that time, yeah.
But over the past month, the keepers have noticed subtle changes in Kura.
She's not really wanting to go outside every day. When she does, she wants to come back in. We're just struggling to kind of get her at the weight that we would like. She's showing more kind of submissive behaviours, not being kind of the matriarch anymore. It's a real shock, and the first time I saw it, yeah, it was quite upsetting because it's like, oh, something has changed. You're not the same lion that you were.
Kura became a Kiwi in the late 90s.
Kura came all the way from Indianapolis Zoo in America. She came here when she was just over a year of age.
Since then, she's had 9 cubs and grown into a fiercely protective mum.
A lot of the success of our pride has really been down to her.
Now, almost 2 decades later,
hey, Koo.
She's well into her twilight years.
She was definitely slower and a bit stiffer.
And zoo staff are worried about her health.
Wild animals are really good at hiding the fact that they're ill, even if they walk okay. And sometimes, even if the x-rays look okay, that animal can still be in pain. It's just masking it. If we get our job right, we can step in and euthanise an animal before it's suffered.
But that can be controversial. Overseas, zoos have been accused of putting animals down too early or without good reason.
At what point do you believe the zoo should intervene in the life of an animal?
We intervene when we have a clear indication that their standard of welfare is potentially starting to decline. The worst thing we can do is to hang on to an animal when physically or mentally it is no longer having a good life. You do not want a situation where an animal starts to suffer. Okay? If an animal is starting to suffer, you have waited too long.
For Kura, that means a tough call.
So her quality of life is started to be impacted, and I don't think there's anything we can do from a veterinary point of view to give her that quality of life back.
The team has made the heartbreaking decision to euthanise their lion queen.
What was it like when you realised that that decision was going to be made?
Sorry. It shouldn't be a surprise. Like, it's something that we plan for. We have known is coming because of just her age. But it doesn't really make it any easier. It's bittersweet because you know you're making the right decision for the animal, but you know that that means that you're not going to see them anymore. Yep.
But by losing Kura...
You're going to sit down? Oh.
Amira will be left by herself.
With lions being such social animals, it really creates a bit of a dilemma around what you do when you just have one left.
The problem we face is that we've got 2 elderly lionesses that have spent their entire lives together. And if mum dies, you know, what decision do we have to then make about the daughter?
Amira was born at Auckland Zoo. She spent her whole life in this enclosure.
If she's ever separated from mum, she really frets. If her mum was to go and not be there anymore, she'd be incredibly anxious, really upset, and that would probably lead to a lot of stress-related issues.
At 17, Amira is too old to be paired up with lions from other zoos.
If we were to try and integrate her with another lion, then there's going to be fights, severe injuries, and honestly, probably her death.
Why can't you just wait and see how Amira copes after Kura dies?
We've already seen how Amira is when she's left by herself even for half a day while mum goes for an anaesthetic or a health checkup, and she gets very distressed. And put her through that for an extended period of time, it's just not acceptable.
So you believe that for her own mental welfare, you have to euthanise?
It's the kindest thing to do. We've always thought in the back of our minds that, you know, if Kura goes, then it's best that Amira goes with her mum.
So obviously it's a very tough and emotional decision for us all, isn't it? Mm-hmm. But I think the right thing for the animals is for them to go peacefully together. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can you understand why this will upset some people? You're killing a healthy lion.
I can understand why people would be upset by it, but this is not a decision that we take lightly. This is not a decision we take in a flippant way.
Is any part of this about protecting the public from having to see sick or elderly animals?
Absolutely not, no. This is about protecting the animals from that.
Is this about saving money on medical costs?
Oh my goodness, no, no, no. This is about doing the right thing for those animals.
Dawn on Wednesday, A day just like every other, except for Kura and Amira.
So they're going to hand inject Kura first.
Before the gates opened to the public, the team that has spent years keeping the lions alive prepared to end their lives.
It requires strength for everyone in the team, but I suppose particularly as a team leader on the day, you do have to be strong, even if, you know, you are hurting as well.
The lions will be having their favourite food. They'll have their injection of anaesthetic. And that'll make them go to sleep.
Yeah. Have a look at your watch and let us know.
And then once they're asleep, we then give them other drugs into their vein, which will send them deeper and deeper, and ultimately they won't wake up.
Within minutes, it's over.
And now we have to go away and deal with our own emotions about it.
It's not until the vets have done what they need to do that it really sinks in. They're like my first lions that I worked with. And they always hold a special place in your heart because they just teach you so much.
For Lauren, the courage to get through this comes from Kura.
She's really displayed a lot of strength and leadership. Through watching her, like, I understand more what that means, like, to be a good leader.
Still a bit surreal that it's happened, but it couldn't have gone any better for the two girls, and just really pleased that they're at peace and just gutted, but it's the right thing.
Kura and Amira will leave a legacy, not just in this zoo, but in the world of animal science.
We will also do a full post-mortem. We can learn a lot of information that can help us help future lions.
For the first time in 60 years, this enclosure is empty. But three new young lions will arrive next year as the zoo's circle of life continues.
Is this worth it for you?
Yep, it is.
Despite the heartache that comes with this?
It's totally worth it. It's hard, but it's worth it.
Well, the number of lions in the wild has dropped by over a third in the last 20 years, partly due to losing their natural habitat and being killed by humans. We'll keep you posted on Auckland Zoo's new lions due here next year.